Imagine being born with a disability. Something simple like you have one leg shorter than the other. Or maybe you were born blind. In the country of India, 1.3 billion people believe that you were cursed by the gods because you have done something horribly wrong in another life. The Hindus call it karma. The system which divides Hindus into rigid hierarchical groups based on their karma, and dharma, the Hindu word for religion, is generally accepted to be more than 3,000 years old. India's caste system is among the world's oldest forms of surviving social stratification.
There cannot be a more degrading form of social organization than caste. 70 years on, these people, a quarter of India's population, are still enslaved by the caste system.
ये बीमारी चालू होने के पहले हमारा काम अच्छे से चलता था, हमको 200-300 रुपया रोज मिलता था। और जब से ये बीमारी शुरू हुई है तो हमको 100 रुपया रोज, हम 100 रुपये में दिन भर काम करते हैं, तो 100 रुपये में अभी हम घर परिवार चलाते हैं। मेरे घर में दो बेटी है, एक दो तीन बेटे हैं और उनका परिवार है और मैं, ऐसे हम लोग कुल मिला के 13 जन।
Hindus believe in a hierarchy of 4 classes and then a sub-class, something less than a human, and those are called Dalits, or the untouchables. If you are born a Dalit, your time on this planet is merely a punishment. You have no significance, and it's actually against the Hindus' religion to help you, or even be kind.
They are not treated like a human persons, even today.
How are they treated?
They are treated like rubbish.
A Dalit's duty is to serve the other 4 classes, to live a life no one on the planet could possibly live. An American-based Christian nonprofit spearheaded by an Indian-born Catholic priest, Ben Chinnapan, needs your help. This nonprofit, aptly named Dalit Solidarity, desperately needs your support. The foundation supports over 1,500 Dalit families per month. Father Ben currently resides in San Diego, California, where he works as a hospital chaplain for the Veterans Administration. And he has received several accolades and made local news in his hometown of Chicago.
A person in India can touch a cat or a dog, but he will not touch an untouchable.
That's why this man, deemed untouchable by virtue of his birth, has made it his life's work to touch the lives of as many Dalits as he can.
He established Dalit Solidarity to be the voice of the voiceless.
Every day, the newspapers are full of reports of attacks on Dalits, the length and breadth of India. Over the weekend, a 14-year-old girl was multiply raped and murdered in New Delhi. That got 3 paragraphs. The Prime Minister has remained silent.
Dalit Solidarity is committed to the principles of justice and equality for all Indians, regardless of caste, race, gender, or religion. Education plays a critical role in the advancement of any oppressed population. Father has worked diligently to provide Dalit children with opportunities for quality education. 7 years ago, he opened a school for the 16 students. The school is proudly named St. Patrick's Academy, located in Villapuram, India. Today, Dalit Solidarity educates several hundred children, beginning in elementary school and continuing through graduate school. Because of the recent pandemic, you must wear a mask in public places. In order for the Dalit to go to work to earn a meager $1 per day, they must wear a mask. But masks are in a shortage, and Dalits cannot have a mask, so they cannot go to work to even earn the smallest amounts of money. No one will give a mask to a Dalit. Selling a mask to a Dalit is a waste of a good mask. A Dalit was put on this earth to perish. Why give them or sell them a mask? The Dalits are in desperate need of personal protection equipment. Please visit DalitSolidarity.org and pledge a donation to save the Dalits. You may even sponsor a child or family. The time is now. We need to speak up for those who have no voice and protect the lives of all God's children, great and small, today.